In this video, we're gonna learn how to make your eyes sparkle by adding a catchlight. Besides, it also adds depth to your eyes. So are you ready? Who are we waiting for then? Let's get started. Before we begin, I gotta tell you something up front. If the subject's eye already has a catchlight, you don't need to add it. Makes no sense to do it. For example, in this image, as you can see, it already has the light of the softbox. So you don't need to do it. So let's get started with our example today. So today we're gonna add catchlight to this eye. So the first thing that you need to do, you need to determine the source of light. Where is the light coming from and what is the source of light? Number one, determine what is the source of light. So in this case, as it seems, it's the sun. So what's the shape of the source of light? Circle. If the source of light was a softbox, or it was a special kind of LED, or even a light ring, so the catchlight would also have been of the same shape. Hence, in this case, the shape of the source of light is circle, determined. Number two, determine the direction of light. So where is the light coming from? Is it coming from the left? Is it coming from the right? Is it coming from top, bottom? Where is the light coming from? And to determine that, determine the shadows. In this case, as you can see, the shadows are on the left side of his face. Also at the same time, the light, a little bit of light is coming from the right hand side, straight up on his eyes. So this conveys that the light is coming from the right top of the image. So let's remember that. Number one, source of light, the sun, which is round. Number two, direction of light, right top. Okay, so keep that in mind. Now, time to create the catchlight. Create a new layer and make a selection with the circle. With the elliptical marquee tool, select the elliptical marquee tool and the shortcut to which is M. Okay, and then create a tiny circle here. See, guys, catch lights are small. They're not as big as this. They're small. Okay? So once you're satisfied with the size of the circle, press and hold space bar to move it. Remember this shortcut. When you're making a circle with a selection or any other selection, if you want to move the selection while you're still holding your mouse, press and hold space bar and you can move it. Okay? So in this case, I think it should be this small around here. And that's pretty okay. You can also press and hold shift to make sure it's totally a circle. And in this case, you can do that because sun is completely circle. So again, press shift to move. There you go. Now this position is pretty good. You can make it a little smaller and leave it. Now, fill it with white. So make sure the foreground color is white. If it's black, press X to toggle between foreground and background color. If it's some other color, press D and then press X. Okay, now to fill it, press Alt or Option and Backspace. Okay, if you're using a Mac, it would be Option and Backspace, as I said, Alt or Option or Backspace. And if you still cannot do it, use the Paint Bucket tool to fill it with white. Now, once you have filled it with white, Control D, or Command D if you're using a Mac, to deselect it. And then let's add a Gaussian blur. Go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Okay, now keep the values to somewhere around. I cannot tell you the absolute values. Keep the values what you feel right should be the blur of a catchlight. So in this case, I think it's too much. Maybe 10 or 15. What about 15? 15 is not bad. 15 is looking great. Click OK. Now make a copy of this one. To make a copy of this one, press and hold Alt or Option and place the copy right up to the opposite of this and on the iris actually. This is pretty good. Awesome. Now, we need to blur it a little bit more. We would go to filter, and blur, Gaussian blur. Whatever was the blur value of this one, double it up. So if it was 15, keep it 30. Do it. Okay. Now, let's move it a little bit. You can move this too. Now, when you move this one, you cannot move this one. This one is moving. Why? Because this layer is selected. If you want to move this, check auto select, and this automatically selects layers depending upon which object you click on. And sometimes it's a good thing and sometimes it's not a good thing. If the objects are overlapping each other, then you might want to check it off. Okay, so I usually keep it checked off. And this is a perfect position. This is also a good position. Now, let's group both of them. So select both of them, press and hold Control or Command and select both of them. Press Control or Command G. This groups both of them. Now this is looking good, but it needs to be a little modified. So change the blend mode to overlay. Okay. Now it's looking good, but the brightness of the catch light is gone. So all you need to do, also there's one demerit of it. If you change the blend mode to overlay, the catch light just goes off from the dark areas, because if you remember from my blend mode tutorial, overlay darkens everything that is dark, brightens everything that is bright. So it goes off from the dark areas. So you need to make a copy of this group, okay, and decrease the opacity quite a bit and change the blend mode from overlay to pass through or normal. Okay, so this applies to the dark areas also. Now you can adjust it according to your liking. There you go. So let's zoom out quite a bit and let's look at the before and after. So let's make a group of both of these groups. So this is the before, this is the after. If you want to brighten it up even more, you can always go ahead and make a copy of group one. Make a copy of group one, not group two. Okay. And you can increase or decrease the opacity according to your want. 35 is fine for this one. So let's look at the before and after. So this is the before, this is the after. So that's pretty much it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, make sure you give us a like. And also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, click on that bell button so that you don't miss any future tutorials. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating. Also, thanks a lot for watching.